With the spread of fake news, examining a piece of information online has been more difficult. But the good thing is there are efforts to fight misinformation, especially the ones related to Philippine history. And just recently, an online presidential library was launched to commemorate the legacy of the late President Fidel V. Ramos. Now, learning about his trailblazing triumphs will be easier for younger generations. For more on this, let's talk to former Finance Secretary Roberto de Ocampo. He's also the chairman for the FVR Legacy Initiative. Good morning, Sir Roberto. Thank you for joining
us. Good morning, Nikki, and thank you for inviting me to your program.
Right. First off, this online library features the life and the works of former President Fidel V. Ramos. What book titles, what exhibits can we expect to see there?
Well, first of all, this was launched on the occasion of the 95th birthday of President Ramos last Saturday. It is quite comprehensive because it goes all the way to his origins, let's say his birth, his family, and then his career as a military man, and proceeds from there to his presidency and the highlights of his presidency and the documents that were generated during that time, as well as the important policy decisions and laws. Then beyond that, it goes to his post-presidency, because as many know, in spite of the fact that he had left the presidency, he continued to be a guiding beacon of light for, for succeeding administrations and the international community as well. And I doubt if there was any other president who was as prolific in writing and releasing books after his presidency as President Ramos was. So this is rather comprehensive, but not yet complete, because we're still in the process of organizing the rest and inputting them as they become available in a logical form. And I think this will be excellent for students, researchers, the next generations, not only in the Philippines, but throughout the world, because it's easy to access. It becomes indestructible since it's already on the cyberspace. And I think that would be an excellent contribution to history.
And we also know that this is a project of the FVR Legacy Initiative and the Ramos Peace and Development Foundation, together with private partners Ayala Corp and San Miguel Corporation. How involved were FVR's family and friends in this?
Well, I was the chairman, but the one who was, in a sense, my critical partner in this endeavor was no less than the president's daughter, Angel Ramos. Mm. As I said, there is a lot of comprehensive stuff that goes all the way back to his origins. And I'm not as familiar with those, with that era as the family is. At the same time, you have to make sure that that there are no sensitivities of a personal nature that are inadvertently put in the text. And that becomes quite important in terms of asking the opinion, the assistance of family members. And so they were quite active as well.
And this is the first online library organized by a former head of state, not just in the Philippines, but in the Southeast Asian region. Where and when did this idea to put up an online library for FVR start?
I think it happened even while he was still around. So that means that was at least 3 years ago. And part of the reason is because it is almost commonplace in a country like the United States to gather together a presidential library of a physical nature. In the case of President Ramos, he was probably the first president to embrace technology even before technology became fashionable. I remember during our days at the cabinet where each document was actually barcoded at his instructions so that it was very easy to have them filed. It was very easy to retrieve them. And therefore, it even reflects his personality as a very organized person who embraces modern high tech. So he did provide some insights and guidance on how this thing could be produced. And then we began to work on it together with all the members of RPDev, as well as the presidential family.
And sir, you've since said that many scholars from the Philippines and across the globe have acknowledged the legacy of President Ramos as one of the country's greatest presidents. But what would you like him to be remembered for most, and how does the library help in this?
Well, I think the best way to remember him is to to think of the phrase leadership by example. Nobody worked as hard as President Ramos. He was legendary in having even piles of paper and a remote fax machine in his car. He would be up by at least 4:30 a.m. doing work, and then he'd call people like me up at such ungodly hours because he had already read clippings and so forth. So leadership by example is something to remember him by, but that leadership by example produced some of the most landmark policies that up to now are the foundation of the Philippine economy in the post-EDSA period, including the reform of the tax system, as well as the introduction of what we now call public-private partnerships, or BOT, Build, Operate, and Transfer Law, as it was known then. He was also the first one to introduce the private sector into the APEC, and that was the birth of what we now know as ABAC, or the APEC Business Advisory Council. Because of this, he was recognized not just as an important domestic leader for the Philippines, but probably was one of the most impactful in the international community among our leaders.
Mm-hmm. And Sir Roberto, it's also fitting that the launch was held at the National Museum of Fine Arts, as it is one of the key legacies of the Ramos administration. Tell us about how you collaborated with the National Museum and the timeline of the project.
It was fitting and to some extent appropriate, because the National Museum had its beginnings with President Ramos. You will recall that that used to be the Congressional Building. One side was the Senate, the other side was Congress. And then farther down the street, you had the Agrafina Circle, which housed the Agriculture Department and the Finance Department, and the Luneta Park was in between them. During his days, President Ramos had this vision of turning that entire area into something similar to the Smithsonian area in Washington, D.C., where you have a large park surrounded by important museums, in order to make sure that the Philippines has its own residence for its historical documents and artifacts, for people to be able to go and see them, for students to learn from the past. And that was the beginning. So it was, I think, absolutely appropriate that the National Museum, which was a brainchild of President Ramos, and was put up during his time, would be the venue for launching the first online presidential library.
Agreed. And Dr. Diokampalasi, before we let you go, where can we access this online library? Is it open to all online, or is signing up needed?
Mm-hmm. Yes, with high tech now, you can access it on your mobile phones, you can access it on your iPads, laptops, whatever, just by keying in fvrlegacy.com. Capital letters for FVR. And once you key that in, it will open the library, and you'll be able to guide your instrument to whatever subject matter interests you. And there are also footnotes that bring you to more detail about certain documentation, about certain policies that would likewise be there.
All right. On that note, thank you so much for speaking to us this morning, Dr. Diokampo. Thanks for your time.
Thank you. Thank you.